Hey guys, welcome to the web series on web development using Angular. This is a video series by the channel Rise and Shine, and this is a third session in this video series, that is web development using Angular. In this session, we are going to discuss in brief about building blocks of Angular application, or what are the code construct of any Angular application. So let us start and go Angular. So what are the building blocks of Angular application? The very first building block of any Angular application is module. And second is component. Component contains template, a metadata, and services, and another component is a directives. Again, some components are there, such as routers, pipes. We will see directives, router, pipes in upcoming session. So in this session, we are going to cover modules, component. What do you mean by template? What do you mean by metadata? And what are the services, or what do you mean by services? And finally, this session concludes with a summary of whole session. So what is Angular module? So Angular contains so many modules. So every Angular application is a collection of many individual modules. Modules are nothing but they are some related group of code. So module allow you to separate the functionality of your application in independent parts. So modules are nothing but they are separate code, independent part of your application. So as they are independent means each module output is a separate or independent of another module. Or we can say that if we change any module, or if there is a change in any one of module, it will does not affect the other modules inside the application. They are independent part, group of some similar code. Or you can call as Angular module group of related coding in a single unit. Whatever the related coding we are making, it is as a single unit. Or Angular module can be loaded eagerly when application start, or sometimes these modules also loaded lazily and asynchronously. So as this figure represents, there are so many modules in Angular applications, or so many types of modules in any Angular application. So Angular app module is nothing but it is a group of related code into a single unit, and such a single unit can be imported in an application or can be exported from an application. So at last or end of day, Angular module is a code which is interacting with each other, render the view of application in web browser. So modules, again, what do you mean by module? So Angular application contains so many modules. So Angular app or modular, every Angular app is a modular in nature, and Angular has also its own modularity system. So what is that system? Every Angular app has at least one module, at least one module class. It is called as root module, or conventionally it is named as app module. It is named as app module or root module, and every application has it. Whether that application is small or large, every application has it. That module we call as root module or app module. While the root module may be the only module in small application, or most of Angular app have many more feature module. What do you mean by feature module? It is a group of code, which is a cohesive block of code dedicated to an application domain or so workflow. So there are so many feature modules available in Angular modular system such as form module, HTTP module, root module. So there are so many feature module. We are using that feature module while building our Angular application. Or Angular ships a collection of JavaScript module. So you can think of them as library modules. So you can install them using some facility which is provided by Angular, that is npm facility. We will see how to import such, how to install such JavaScript modules in our application. And they are using import facility of JavaScript, we can import the part of such JavaScript modules. So this is all about the Angular modules and the modularity system of any Angular application. So each Angular module allows to group together other building blocks of application, such as component and services, as well as directive and pipe. So diagrammatically we can see, suppose this is Angular module which allow us to group together component, services, directives and pipes. And again, these services are injected in component as and when needed, or these services can use by n number of component or many number of component in Angular application. So Angular module is nothing but it allows to group together the other building blocks such as components, services injected inside the component, directives and pipes. Again, another building blocks also imported in a Angular module, such as routers. So we'll see what you mean by directive, pipes, router in next upcoming session. So next we are going to see the next building block of any Angular application, that is components or component. What do you mean by this component? So component are the key feature of any Angular application. It is a key feature. It is a basic building block of any Angular application. So all Angular application or whole Angular applications are built using different components, and these components are related with each other. Our component are the reusable part which you can reuse very easily to build the application, or you can reuse this component from one application to another application. So this component control and covers the portion of the view on the web browser. So to betterly understand this point, consider this is a view of www.gmail.com in a web browser. So what do you mean by component? So component control and cover the portion of web browser. For example, this is one component, or it is called as header component. This is second component, which is called as sidebar component. And this is again a third component, or it is called as main content component. In this way, we can divide whole web browser into component, or we can nest the component inside the component. For example, this compose. For example, this compose is again one component. This search mail text box is again one component. Here also in this sidebar we can nest the component inside the component. So every Angular application is built using such different components. So they are the basic building block or the key feature of any Angular application. So I think you understood what you mean by component. So it control and covers the portion of the view on web browser. Or you can, here I have divided the browser into three components. You can divide it into five components also: header component, sidebar component, that is a right sidebar, left sidebar, as well as footer component also. Sometimes they are called as nav bar or navigation bar, the header is so different terminologies used. So component are the key feature or basic building block of Angular application. So this component again contains, or it is made up of template, a class, and metadata. So we'll go one by one. What do you mean by template? It represents the view created using HTML and CSS. Template will be the user interface for application represented in the browser. So this template part of component handles the user interface. We already seen that Angular application supports MVC architecture. So whatever the view part, it is handled by the component template, which is created using HTML and CSS. Next part of component is a class. So component have a class, which is nothing but a TypeScript code. A class supports the view created by template part, whatever the first part. So this class supports the whatever the view created in the browser by the template. And this class also contains the data properties and member method. As we have seen class in another programming language, they are also having data properties and member methods. So same concept is here. So this TypeScript class controls the view or user interface, whatever the actions or the event are fired from that user interface that are handled by this class. Or it controls the data on that view. Or sometimes whenever we are changing the view layer data, automatically the data at this class level is also get changes, which is called as data binding property. So how to bind this data and how this template and class work together to pass on the data, we will see in upcoming session, that is called as data binding. Now, time being, you consider there are three parts. First is template, which is HTML and CSS, user interface of application, and which is supported or handled by one TypeScript class. Next thing every component is having is a metadata. So metadata is attached to this second component, that is class. This information, this metadata is used by Angular to decide the particular class is a component or a simple class or whether it is a service. So this metadata is defined using decorated, which is the one of the feature of TypeScript. So the component decorator is defined using @component_var. So decorator is nothing but it is a block of code which contains the metadata about this component or metadata about component class. So every Angular application have at least one component, and it is called as root component. It's called as root component, or conventionally it is called as app component. So within app component there is a one template and one class. So every whatever the blocks you are seeing here, app component, header component, sidebar, main component, other component, some. So every box is contained two part again. So one part is a template HTML and another part is a class, which is TypeScript. So every Angular application have at least one component, which is called as a root component or app component. And this app component, within this app component, other component are nested, that is header component, sidebar component, main component, or footer component. Again, within this sidebar component, we can embed another component, that is other component. Within other component, we can again nested some component. So using such all component, we can render the view of application in a browser. So all other component are nested within root component. Other component are again nested in any of this component. So in this way, you can do the nesting of component within another components. Next, every module, as every module we have seen is having component, they are also contains the services. To betterly understand services, consider, suppose we want to consume a data in Angular application from a server. That is, we want to fetch some data, whether it is a database server or any application server. We want to fetch the data in our Angular application at our front end. So we have to do it in a following way. That is, we have to write a code to retrieve that data. We have to write some code, some HTTP code or something to retrieve that data. So we can write this data inside component itself, but this is very bad option. It has some drawback, such as the application modularity feature get disturbed. That is, whenever we are including such code inside our component class, which supports the view, our modularity feature get disturbed. That is, whatever that MVC architecture, it get disturbed. Also, the unit testing of component code become difficult. That is, every time we have to make that connection virtually, or we have to use some another facility to do that connections, and our unit testing become a difficult task. Or if we want to fetch the data at multiple component in our application, then we have to write the same logic to fetch the data in each and every component where we want that facility. That is, there is our code rewrite problem is get arise. And when we rewrite the same code, there is a possibility of bug in our application. So bug get introduce when we rewrite the same code, or whenever we rewrite the code, maintenance get increased. So these are the problem with this option. If we write the code for fetching the data from server inside the Angular application, so what is the solution then to maintain that modularity circuit? Solution to this problem is make a separate code where we write the logic to retrieve the data from server or database. So separate that code from the component class code. And once we separate that code, we can reuse that code at multiple places in Angular application where we want that logic or want that service. So this solution or writing such a code separately in Angular is called as services. So what do you mean by services? A service is typically a TypeScript class with a narrow and well-defined purpose. That is, we are writing that class for some purpose. For example, fetching data from database or to do the application configuration. So that class is having specific, a single purpose. And we can use such a class at any component in our Angular application. Next, services means data or logic that doesn't associate with specific view and that you want to share across multiple components. So in that case, you write a separate class, and that separate class is nothing but a service or services. That is, sometimes some data and logic is not associated with the view of application. That is, they are not render any element on web browser. So such a logic we can write separately. For example, fetching a data from server. It is not a code related to the view layer. So it is a business logic. So we can write such business logic in separate classes. Services. So a service class definition is immediately preceded by the @ injectable decorator. Again, in last slide, we have seen decorator means it is a one feature TypeScript, or it is a block of code to represent the metadata. So to represent the metadata of this service class, we use @injectable_decorator. So it is code attached to a service class. And component delegate their functionality to the services. So how we are creating the services? If component want some functionality, they delegate it to services. For example, fetching a data from component, we are not writing that code in component code, but we will write separate code. Means component is delegating that functionality to another separate class, and that separate class is nothing but a service. So anything can be a service in Angular application. For example, logging service, data fetching service, message bus, application configuration, tax calculation, anything, any calculation, any mathematical calculation which is need of that application, but which is not associated with specific view or UI layer functionality. So whatever the business logic, business layer functionality, we are writing it in a separate class, and that separate class is nothing but the services. So summary of this session: every Angular application contains one or more module, and the root module of application is called as app module, and it is a basic module, or every Angular application has this app module. Each module contains one or more component classes and service classes. Every application has one or more component, and every application has one component. It's called as root component or app component. And these components have the metadata, which is represented with decorators. And each component contains HTML template, a TypeScript class, and metadata defined with the help of decorator @component. Also, every module can contain services, which contains the business logic of the application. These services also, these services are also typical classes with @injectable_decorator, which is metadata again. And in Angular application, module can be imported, exported. They interact with each other, and at the end of that, ultimately render the view of application in web browser. So this is all related to basic building block or code construct for any Angular application. Hope guys, this session is informative for you people. So it is my request, kindly like, share, and subscribe our channel Rise and Shine, which contains the infographical information or presentational videos from KG to PG and from simple stotras to syntax. So guys, thank you very much. Keep watching, keep listening. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you.